morning about changes that need to be made in our life, and I was thinking, in order to make the right decisions and to get on the right track, you gotta look at some things in your personal life. So I want to invite you to open your Bibles, if you would, to the book of Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1. It says, "Be ye therefore followers of God as dear children, and walk in love as Christ also hath loved us and hath given himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling savor." So we're talking about how to make the right decision. It's right there on the screen. It says, "Be followers of God." This year we have the theme, "Follow Me." And the theme is going to be throughout the entire year. There's many different aspects of following Jesus Christ, and certainly you cannot be a disciple of Jesus Christ unless you're following him. In order to follow him, you need to keep your eyes on him, and you need to listen to his voice. So that's how you begin to learn how to follow him. I want to talk about some consequences of decisions we make. If you want to make good decisions, one way to do that, there's different ways to look at it, but one of those is to consider the consequences of the decisions you make. Every decision you make, the actions you take, or the things that you don't do, have consequences. And so it's very important for us to consider that. If you turn over your Bibles to the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, it's one of the first five books of the Bible, the very important part, because it's dealing with Moses and Joshua. And in this passage, we're going to deal with Joshua and the moving into the land of Canaan, the promised land, and how it is that they were told they could be blessed by God. And if we take a look at Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1, it says, "And it should come to pass if," you could draw a circle around that word in your Bible, "if," it's a condition, "if thou shalt hearken," that means listen diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, "to observe to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, then the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth." So it's a condition. It says, if you will listen. Sometimes people hear what you're saying. Kids are kind of that way. They hear what you say, but they don't always let you know that they heard what you said, right? They hear what you say, but they don't want to hear it. They don't want to receive it. So they just hear it, but don't kind of act like they didn't hear that at all, right? That's what happens when people are not listening and accepting what you're saying. And it's especially important when we're talking about God. And he says, "If you shall hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and do all his commandments, which I command you this day, the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth." Conditional. He says, "I'm going to bless you if you listen to me." And it says, "And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee if thou shalt hearken or listen unto the voice of the Lord thy God." And looking on in this passage in verses 3 and 4, it says, "Blessed shalt thou be in the city, and blessed shalt thou be in the field. Blessed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of the ground, and the fruit of thy cattle, the increase of thy kine, and the flocks of thy sheep. Blessed shall be thy basket and thy store. Blessed shalt thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shalt thou be when thou goest out. The Lord shall cause thine enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come out against thee one way, and flee before thee seven ways." So what he's saying is, the condition is, if you will listen to God and accept what he's saying to you, then if you listen to God and obey what he's telling you, he will bless you and save you. So when it says be followers of God, it means to be an imitator of God. The Greek word translated followers is the word from which we get mimic. It's the Greek word that means mimic, to mimic or copy or become like the person you're following. Our entire conduct must become like that of our Lord. Our entire conduct. spirit, our desires, just like children will copy parents or copy their peers, they will copy other people. We're supposed to mimic God. By the way, if you get closer and closer and closer to God and you keep following Him in your life will be transformed by being with Him and knowing Him and yielding yourself to become like Him, to mimic Him, to copy Him. And you can't compare yourself to other people. Sometimes people say, well, I'm a good person. Well, you know why they think they're a good person? Because they're comparing themselves with other people. The one that we need to compare ourselves with is the Lord, and He's holy. He's perfect, not like us. And so we can't compare ourselves to other people. Look at 1 Peter, 1:15. But as He which hath called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation. Because it's written, be ye holy, for I am holy. Holy means to be separate from God. It means to be separate, not from God. It means to be separate from sin. It means to be set. Holy is a word that means to be separated. So when you say, I'm holy, I'm separated from the ways of the world, and I'm separated unto God. I want to become like God. I'll make sure I say that right. So you want to be separated to God and away from the ways of the world. That's to be holy. And we're supposed to become an imitator, a follower of God. It doesn't say think about God. It doesn't say admire God. It's a call to live out our faith in God as we follow Him. Look at Ephesians chapter 4, verse 13. It says, till we all come in the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, under the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. And on verse 32, it says, be kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. What I'm saying is that as you listen to God and as you follow Him, and keep your eyes on Him and His ways, then we're supposed to come until we have a unity of faith in Him, trust Him, and become mature and complete like Him. And it says, and if we do that, we're going to be kind and tender-hearted and forgiving, even as God, for Christ's sake, forgave us. That's the way it's supposed to be. So, when you talk about making a good decision in 2017, one is you've got to consider the consequences of the choices you